My name is Auriel Willette. I'm a research scientist in the Department of Food Science and Human Nutrition, as well as the neuroscience graduate program here at Iowa State University. And what we're looking at in the study is whether or not people with insulin resistance, that is the inability for insulin to do its job in the brain and in muscle, was related to problems with regulation of blood sugar in the brain, because that has been linked to problems with cognition, like memory, for instance, and learning. And what we basically found was that in a very strong fashion, that indeed higher insulin resistance was related to less glucose uptake, less glucose use, in many of the same brain regions that are impacted by Alzheimer's disease, and that show the same relationship with less glucose use over time. What was really interesting was that there was the most focal result was in a part of the brain called the left medial temporal lobe, and this is probably the first area where we start really seeing the effects of Alzheimer's disease taking place. And so in this late middle-aged cohort, no cognitive problems whatsoever, we see that there is this biological mechanism, insulin resistance, that is predicting things that we would normally see in Alzheimer's disease. The other part of this study that I really think is important is for people in the here and now who have insulin resistance and more of it, that it's not just impacting glucose use and that, that's related to Alzheimer's disease later on. It actually is itself impacting their memory for things that they've just immediately begun to learn, as well as things that they're trying to remember 5 minutes from now, 20 minutes from now, perhaps even hours, days, weeks from now. And so that health factor, that problem with metabolism, that obesity in general, is impacting our ability to think. Not to a great degree, but there is still something concerning that perhaps we should kind of focus more on that, and it's not just these diseases that'll happen on down the line, but this actually is kind of impacting our ability to work, to play even, in the here and now. The problem with clinical research in the past had been that we were trying to stop the disease when people already had it. And at that point, there are a huge number of issues that we have to tackle. And so rather than focusing on sort of a cure, nowadays we're focused more on prevention. And so in that case, we want to go back not just to when people are having some memory problems, but we want to go all the way back to when people are cognitively normal. That is, they can remember just fine, they don't have any problems with activities of daily living, anything else like that. And the thought is, if we can figure out exactly why people are having these issues, related to, say, insulin resistance, for example, or other things, then we can perhaps treat that. And that hopefully then we can either delay the onset of Alzheimer's or maybe even stop it altogether.